Undertaker stalking. Somewhere along the way, Edge is going to lose that smile.
Yeah, well, I think you might be right, but look at this here.
And team up.
Edge picked his spot.
Oh, my God.
Not many want to throw hands with the Undertaker, but Edge is doing it. You look back at all the competition that the Undertaker has to beat. Oh, man. And that was a scintillating shot right to the face. I don't know if any athlete in the history of the WWE has given the Undertaker more problems than Edge.
Well, I think you're right about that. Watch this. Straight up boot. Right in the face. I think that might just be the beginning of the brutality we might witness here.
Physicality personified here in Satan's structure. Over the top.
That's where you know, see, that's where the problems begin. Once you get outside of the ring structure, then you're around that demonic structure that is just unforgiving. That cell will pick apart your body, which picks apart our careers.
The Hell in the Cell is almost like a living being itself. It likes to select its victims. And these two men, before this night is over, The Undertaker and Edge will no doubt become victims of the Hell in the Cell.
Again, the physicality right here, baby. Spine first into the steel care of the dead man. And JR, I know you've called the first Hell in a Cell match. I mean, in your opinion, has the violence of this match amped up over the years?
I think simply because the aggression between The Undertaker and Edge is what makes this Hell in a Cell so special and so unique.
Well, the dead man in complete control. And the intensity of The Undertaker is just unmatched.
You see that chain locking the door. These men are locked inside the structure. Again, it does have a roof on it.
Well, that's no rules. And just imagine the bodily damage The Undertaker can cause in the cell. And just think, we just saw some of that. It's not even comfortable being this close to the cell, JR. This thing's about 10 feet away from us, man, the size of it.
Very intimidating to sit on the outside. One can only imagine what it would be like to be on the inside. I choose not to ever find out.
Yeah, I second that emotion.
There can be no count out to disqualifications here, ladies and gentlemen. That may go without saying. And there is our SmackDown General Manager, Vicky Guerrero, and her family, Chavo Guerrero, Tag Champions Hawks, looking on. Undertaker enjoying this methodical pace that he has set out on to physically dissect his adversary.
Well, yeah, and again, we talk about physicality and aggression. Look at the dead man, the height. Not only that, the athletic ability, the height of the Undertaker. Oh, boy.
All legal. Completely legal. Steel, the silver, the color of the night.
Not good right now for the rated R superstar here. And what does the dead man have in mind? Bad intentions, I think.
Undertaker placing the ring steps seemingly where he wanted them. And now where will the Undertaker place Edge? Uh-oh. Here it comes. There it is. I think Edge caught himself in the V there, the steps. And now the Undertaker is the one that feels the steps that the Undertaker brought into the ring.
Like it or not, you gotta give Edge credit. That was a phenomenal counter. I thought Edge drilled his own head into the steps.
That basement drop kick driving the Undertaker's head. The spear all against the ring steps. Again, that the Undertaker brought into the ring. And now we're seeing Edge show some innovative and yet destructive offense.
Well, Edge did say that he would show the Undertaker the purest form of hell. And this might be the beginnings of it, JR.
Edge, certainly a tables, ladders, and chairs expert. Here's another
one. He blocked it, and then Edge was able to stop the Undertaker.
The great counter follows again more usage of these steel steps. Undertaker may be regretting that he brought those steps into play.
Undertaker might not know where he is right about now. But Edge,
that one table's obviously not enough for whatever Edge is thinking.
Yeah, look at the spear here while Undertaker's trapped. Oh. Nowhere for the dead man to go. Watch.
Oh. That steel and cranium coming together. And again, high impact from Edge taking down the Undertaker.
I got to tell you, Jerry, I am impressed with Edge right now. I'm telling you, man. It just seems like that confidence, you could see it in his face. His eyes, he believes in himself, and that's a huge part of being in a match with The Undertaker in the cell.
I thought coming into this match at Edge in that psychopathic state would be a little bit out of control. But Edge seemingly willing to ravage his own body to win this match. And that's what's all about here. Look out here. And it's all about winning and maybe surviving. Undertaker had to be thinking choke slam. At least that's my assumption.
Well, I think Edge just saved himself right there, because the dead man looked like he was going Doozle City to Edge. Now watch.
Oh. In the chair. Legal in the first ever Hell in a Cell match in SummerSlam history. So now we have seen the table set up.
Now watch this. Look. Oh. It looks, seem to be the edge of the chair into the throat of The Undertaker. That'll definitely incapacitate anybody, even The Undertaker.
Edge making sure he went down, went right for the spine of The Undertaker. And now
look at Edge's eyes here, JR. Look at it. Oh. Talk about aggression and intensity and desire to be victorious. I tell you, I'm impressed with Edge.
Oh, another hard, vile steel chair shot to the spine. The second one to The Undertaker's spine in this match.
We've seen over the years, though, JR, The Undertaker can sustain punishment. He is tough for that matter.
Undertaker's pain threshold is off the charts. Does it compare with anyone I've ever seen?
Edge, he's spending a lot of time. He's grabbing all sorts of furniture under this ring here.
Edge said earlier on SmackDown that his brain was burning from the inside out, but it looks like Edge is certainly a master strategist here tonight.
What is that? It looks like two ladders out here. As you pointed out, Edge's expertise with TLC matches. We got some tables, and we got some ladders, and a chair in hand.
And another hard steel chair shot. Certainly was not on the spine, but takes The Undertaker down, and Edge is doing a lot of housekeeping here and rearranging.
Listen, Jay, I have no idea what Edge's game plan is here, his strategy. I have no idea, but he obviously does have some sort of a plan.
We have seen so many transformations and metamorphosis of Edge in the last few weeks. We're seeing another here tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what, JR, you can call Edge twisted, whatever. You can call whatever you want, but this persists tonight. You're going to call him the winner, man, in this Hell in a Cell match.
Edge in his first Hell in a Cell match. Here tonight at SummerSlam against The Undertaker.
Look at Edge here. Look at the aggressiveness. You got to be kidding me.
Vile, evil, nasty aggression by the R-rated superstar.
You got to assume that The Undertaker might not have a clue where the heck he is right about now.
But you said earlier, a great point, Undertaker can take a pounding, but how much more can the human anatomy take?
I think Edge is about to test The Undertaker's resiliency for pain.
Remember what Edge did to Mick Foley. And he said the same thing. Understand. Ed said the same thing before he destroyed Mick Foley with that same maneuver. The Undertaker tasting the wood and the steel.
I cannot believe the control that Edge has. Look at this. I understand.
That's scary. That is evil. And we had a near fall, our first near fall of the contest. Edge looking for a cover, got a two count. I'm surprised that we haven't seen a pin attempt, but I think what it really illustrates is the mental frame of mind of both these men. Let's maim and destroy.
Well, Edge is just pulling out all the stops, and I'll tell you, like it or not, that's what you have to do. Oh, wait a minute.
We know what's coming now, ladies and gentlemen. It won't be pretty, the concerto. And the Undertaker sets off, saves himself, at least for the time being, in a thunderous right hand.
The heavy-hitting Undertaker just dropped Edge with one straight-up punch. But can the Undertaker capitalize?
And to think that the Undertaker's career, after being banished, received a reprieve from SmackDown's general manager, Mrs. Edge.
All the punishment Edge has given to the Undertaker thus far in this matchup. Well, look at the ribs of our Edge. You see that gigantic, like a big welt, like a swelled up bruise of sorts.
Take a look at this. Watch this.
Hey, look, man. There's nothing pretty about that. Boot meets face, face, and body meets self.
This is a match where casualties are guaranteed. And the Undertaker again. Look out! Right in the side of the head.
Turnabout's fair play, they say, JR.
Edge may have been lucky to turn his head at the last moment, or he'd have been hit right between the eyes with those steel steps. Well, listen to this.
Here it comes.
Again, steel and cranium meet. You don't have to guess who wins.
Edge's spaghetti leg. The dead man, he's not looking too good himself. He's hurting also.
Oh, the Undertaker's head and shoulder against the steel ring post. Edge able to put on the brakes. Edge saving himself there.
Here he comes. Oh, oh.
Cage is just imploded.
I can't believe what we just witnessed here. The spear through the center. The impact, as you said, JR.
I got a whole heck of a lot closer to the Hell in a Cell than I ever wanted to be. It's right here on top of us. And look at my right hands. The Undertaker and Edge exchanging right hands.
It's like a street fight right here, JR. Watch out. Oh. Oh, I got a kick.
These two men outside the steel. Where will this one go? How will this
end?
And Edge's head bouncing off the steel.
Well, I'll tell you what, the hell's not only in the cell, the hell's out here.
Edge going for the That steel, that security wall didn't move an inch.
I never expected this, JR. Out of the cell, and it's breaking down worse than in the cell.
And Undertaker looking to plant Edge on a television monitor. Edge and the Undertaker getting extreme. There's a shot. The crack of that monitor to the Undertaker's head was this.
Definitely slowed down to Devin. Oh, another one. Yeah, look at the impact here.
Look at the impact. Hear the impact. Feel the impact.
Again, Edge just in control here, JR.
Now watch.
From east to west, north to south.
I can't believe what I just witnessed. I'm telling you, I'm about 10 feet from it. The impact right now we just witnessed. Insane. Just watch this.
Heads running across two announce tables. Spear. What impact. A collision. A hit. Anatomies.
Unreal. I can't believe this match, JR. Phenomenal.
These two men, the impact has destroyed the cell. These two men are destroying each other. Are we seeing two amazing careers be drastically shortened here tonight?
Yeah, I think we are. In my opinion, I definitely think we're seeing careers shortened a bit here.
This is amazing. Amazing.
Okay, look at the impact here. God almighty.
Edge wasn't walking on water. He was running on wood. And emotion, and now the Undertaker somehow is back up.
Yeah, right out of here in front of us again. Oof! Another look at an insane spear and a street fight right here in front of us, JR.
Undertaker challenging Edge. The throw in my head. Hit me in the head. Bring it with all you've got.
Let's go, Taker.
I tell you, I don't think either of these men know where they are right now. It's not possible.
This has been an amazing aggression, amazing perseverance, the will to survive, to compete, to win this match at SummerSlam is absolutely, it's unexplainable. Well,
listen, by any means necessary, more or less, the desire of both athletes.
And Edge with that trusty ladder, perhaps his best friend in this match, the ladder striking the Undertaker.
I mean, Vicky, I guess, liking what she's seeing right now, I guess.
I don't know, that's her husband in there still. Better or for worse.
Uh-oh. Well, I'll tell you, Edge right now, I didn't think Edge would be able to do what he's done thus far in this match. I am impressed, but.
Oh my God, this is shades of the last Hell in a Cell match. This is exactly what cost The Undertaker the title at Survivor Series last year inside Hell in a Cell.
All legal, JR.
Edge was
history repeats itself here, JR.
Dressed as a killer man. The cover. Will it be? No, it's not over.
How much closer can you get?
Man, it has been an emotional day here. I know that our general manager from SmackDown, Vicky Guerrero, has been surrounded by her family all day, certainly concerned about what Edge might do during the day.
Yeah, that they've been sequestered. And I think they were just as concerned about the Undertaker as the one with Edge. Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
Edge's biggest fear.
Here we go.
Choke slam!
Talk about high
lord! What a choke slam!
He's got to be!
Can it be?
Oh, man!
I'm not believing this.
Did you see how high in the air Edge was?
A slam dunk of a choke slam from the Demon of Death Valley, and Edge was able somehow, some way, to kick out of it.
Oh.
Low blow! Legal inside Hell in a Cell. And I'm sure the cell is enjoying the carnage that we're all witnessing here tonight. The Devil's Playground has indeed been just that.
I'm lost for words. I cannot remember the last time I've witnessed two men in the cell have at it like we're witnessing right now.
The Impaler DDT. Edge now looking to finish off the Undertaker.
Might get him with that. Might get him here.
He could. And referee Scott Armstrong got a two count. But Edge has a distinct advantage as we speak.
Well, we talked about the amount of punishment that the Undertaker can take. Uh-oh.
Oh, this could get ugly. Uglier. Undertaker buried it right here. A body shot. The double over edge.
That might have been the most important body shot the Dead Man threw.
Big time body shot. Undertaker.
Oh, whoa.
Undertaker, what's...
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Wait a minute. You don't think that... Undertaker.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, hey, hands off the backside.
Oh, God.
Undertaker.
That's it.
It's over. It's over.
Got him.
Is it over?
Got him.
I don't know anymore. I thought it was over. And then you think it's the Undertaker.
Look at that counter here by Edge. And a spear. And another spear to the Dead Man care of Edge.
Edge has brought his spear, his chair, his tables, his ladders, all to throw at the Undertaker.
Hey, listen, and Edge brought his A-game too, JR. Don't forget that. Like it or not, he did, I'm telling you.
I'm not arguing with you. Another right hand. I said earlier that the Undertaker has had more problems with Edge than any other WWE superstar. I think that fact has been proven in this match, if it wasn't before.
And no doubt that Edge has rented a lot of space in the head of Undertaker.
Undertaker.
Oh, yes!
The last ride. The last ride.
Got it.
Will it be the last ride? Will it be? The journey continues. What we thought was the literal last ride for the Undertaker.
How did Edge kick out of the last ride? Had to be on instinct. Had to be.
I thought the Undertaker delivering that last ride would have essentially been last rites in a figure of speech. And now the Undertaker thinking something else. Undertaker's trying to use these steel steps on more than one occasion tonight and has effectively.
Well, JR, I got to be thinking it's not just instinct on Edge's part. It's the frame of mind, the frenzy. He's just been off the wall, and he just wants to win this match so bad. And I guess that's how he's able to kick out of stuff that the Dead Man is doing to him.
We thought Edge being psychotic. We thought Edge was willing to see his own body ravaged to win this match, to pay the supreme price. But it may not be that. Undertaker now, play up on that steel steps like a platform, like a gold medal platform.
Got to be kidding here.
Undertaker. Remember those steel chair shots to the spine earlier in this match? The Undertaker his spine met steel again, this time the ring steps. At some point, his back is going to forgive. It's gonna give out.
I think that point might be right about now. Edge looks like he counted the two-star power driver. And as you said, you gotta wonder the condition of the spine of the Dead Man.
Here we go.
Two.
Both men are spent, JR. Just spent.
I don't know how these two men are continuing to compete in this environment after what they put each other through. And this match seemingly is far from over.
You're not kidding. Edge, look at him weary. Look at him. He's hardly stand up. The Dead Man probably don't even know where he is.
Undertaker's back, his spine has got to be hurting him immensely. Undertaker, you can see he's not even standing. And Edge, those free shots with the Undertaker on his knees.
When was the last time you saw the Dead Man in this bad of shape during a matchup? Oh, wait a minute. Whoa.
This is sacrilege. Edge going old school.
Whoa.
And school is out. No recess for Edge, who tried to go old school on the Undertaker. And the right hand by.
Well, that was an uppercut that was nasty. Wait a minute.
Chokeslam through the table to the floor.
Tables! Two tables, JR. Edge looks like he fell off the top of a building.
Man, if that doesn't do it, if this doesn't do it here after being chokeslammed through two tables.
Check this out. How do you explain this? What do you think Edge was thinking in mid-flight? There's no counter, there's nothing you can do.
Under Undertaker now measuring Edge. It is back to the ring. Oh. And Undertaker with a spear. A page out of Edge's book. Retaliation from the Dead Man using Edge's spear on Edge.
I got to think right there during this insanely physical battle.
First the tables, then the spear, and now the tables! Man, that was more than HD. That's human devastation, all right, if that's the HD you're looking at.
Yeah, look at this. It's like everything that Edge has done to the Dead Man. The Dead Man is doing to Edge.
The Undertaker revisiting.
No,
he's tied for the concerto. The Undertaker, to my knowledge, has never used a concerto in his almost two-decade career. This is all a receipt sent back to Edge, a message. You pay for your sins, and now the tombstone. The conscience of the WWE wins Hell in a Cell.
The Undertaker.
One of the most amazing physical confrontations in WWE history. The physicality and the aggression that we have seen from both these men is indescribable. But at the end of the day, the greatest of them all, The Undertaker, is the winner in Hell in a Cell.
Well, we heard Edge say, I'm gonna pull The Undertaker down to hell with me, and Vicky, you too. That didn't happen. The Dead Man, successful.
Vicky, surrounded all day by her family, in fear of the actions of her own husband. But The Undertaker, his legacy has grown to even more unworldly heights here tonight.
What a match it was, though, JR. What a physical contest we witnessed. An amazing Hell in a Cell. There's life in Edge yet, though. Not much.
Edge moving around. The Undertaker saw it on the screen, apparently. And the Demon of Death Valley apparently thinks that his night's work has yet to finish. We saw tables. We saw chairs, we saw the camera, we saw spears, and now we are seeing a ladder.
Yeah, we saw concertos, and I think Edge might be seeing the back of his eyelids shortly.
This match is officially over.
Oh, man. Oh, I have no clue what...
Edge is helpless. Edge is out of it. Edge is coming.
Edge is just laying up on the ladder, just like stuck there. Can he help himself?
Edge is unable to defend himself whatsoever. But what is The Undertaker thinking here now?
It's almost like Edge is melting off the ladder. Is he?
Payback is a steep price sometimes. And
what is going on here? The Dead Man.
We've talked about individuals with mean streaks, with tenacity.
Thank you.
on that ladder.
Watch out!
Chokeslam.